these little bags of popcorn. Mm-hmm. So the little there's nothing special. There's no special events around this bag.
Hello. Okay. So, hello, everyone who may not know, I'm Sydney. I'm Randy's youngest granddaughter, and here I'm with Kalina and my sister Kyra. A little over 10 years ago, in the summer of 2012, Kalina and Kyra had the opportunity to interview our grandmother, and thankfully, we were able to find the recording. We wanted to share with you some of our favorite moments and stories from that recording. So,
Sydney did a lot of her.
Testing.
Yes.
Okay, you're asking questions then. Sometimes you throw one up, you catch three, and you catch the other one. So it's just things like that. They don't have games, no ball game, nothing. So life is quite simple for the children. In those years, my fondest memories with my family, my father was in my family at that time. So every Sunday, we all go to some place together to sightsee or go eat for a lunch. And then when we come back, we always go see a movie. with his other two friends, girlfriends. You know what I mean? He had two other friends, of course, Chinese friends, and they had each girlfriend. These three guys get together all the time, so I'm sharing an apartment with his two other friends, girlfriends, and that's where he puts the apartment. So that's the deal that he asked to marry me. So I said, okay. he's just holding the ring and asked me to, you know, if I want, he can marry me. And he later on, he wrote a letter to my parents to ask them that permission. The wedding is a very simple wedding. There is no dinner, no reserved sandwiches. We are all students, we don't have money. Sandwiches and cake, that's it. Afterwards, we left the ceremony to go to our honeymoon on the East Coast. And we went to Boston too. We went to the border. One bad thing about that is the camera that his father let him use, broken. So we could not take any pictures. We did not get any pictures. So it's bad. All I did, all I do have is the wedding picture. We bought a new car. It's an American made car. We drove about 3,000 or 4,000 miles. It was nice, and I get up at 5 o'clock in the morning. He is still sleeping, so I just got up and wait for him to get up. We just driving every time. Just keep on driving because we want to visit all these places. So we keep on driving. But I learned more about him. He's a nice person, he's a responsible person. So he's poor, no money, but that's okay. We all started with no money, everybody at that time. And so I had a great time. My favorite memories is I just love to see them when they are so peaceful, so quiet, so nice, so kind. When the kids are asleep, it's just so peaceful. You just stay at the door and watch them. What can we do for kids? Early education. Because I would get the same holiday with my children. When they have Christmas, I got. When they go to a pool holiday, I cannot use them at school. So it's very good, most well for me. I don't have to find people to take care of them when they have to go to work. And when they go to school, I go to work. They come home and I'm only working half time. So usually I work at 8 to 1 o'clock and come back. If I need to work, I work longer time before. So I thought I mentioned about my sandwich and the soup in a warmer and then. So I really enjoy the one for 16 years. I really enjoy that because not teaching handicapped kids one skill. Once they learn the skill, I feel so satisfied. One thing that will stick to my mind is I kind of sneeze quite often. If that's the one that sneezes right away. So every time I sneeze, three times in a row, sneeze. So the kids were counting every time I say, this is the end, 1, 2, 3. So they all laugh, and I was just laughing when they did that. The kids is just need a lot of patience. When they are not doing anything, not learning to go, because they're very unfair, like I'm not succeeding at teaching them. But when they learn something, they can do anything. So I like to listen to them. We like to eat lunch, go out eat lunch together, and when somebody comes, some of the children comes, we try to excuse them, get together and eat a meal, and eat my lunch or dinner. But I'm still doing activity with them, and I join the book club. I'm enjoying my book club. We have a good teacher, and she's introduced us to a lot of the old classics, which I never dared to read. With her guidance, we are there to read all kinds of difficult books. So we are having a good time there. Also join the Tai Chi and also our investment club for this family. All of them do this thing together, so we are really close, our community. They're good. Actually, it's not really investment, just like a chit-chat We take a lot of things, so we could just enjoy food and talk. And also after we came about dinner, so it's eating again. After all these foods, we go out to dinner. Oh, in the meantime, I did a lot of traveling with my friends. They were very kind to me, they were nice to me, they improved me in all the activities. So to make my time go faster and then my life a little easier. And of course I have four children and they all gave birth to grandchildren that year, children in 96 and 97. So good thing I had the grandchildren, I was needed to take care, to help them take care of their one newborn baby, so that helped me. And then later on two more grandchildren come. So I have not been working. After I retired, I did not think about working either. Taking care of myself and the house. Kind of keeping busy. We're traveling, going up to Chicago, coming back, and then going to visit Diane.
Your father called me all the time, your mom called me all the time. Actually, they called me all the time. Diane called me all the time. So all these kids phone call make me happy, so that's.
Now I'm getting used to my routine, and so that's it. Nowadays my life is very simple. Just I'm trying to be healthy. Once in a while, I take a trip with family and just enjoy my old age. So now I have 8 grandkids. They are the joy of my life. Hopefully.
Thank you.